In this video, we're going to finish the radical equations hard worksheet on the CUDA software website under the Infinite Algebra 1 section. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this free worksheet. Now, to start in number 22, we're going to have to add in to both sides. And that's in order to move this negative in to the other side of the equation. So adding in to both sides, we'll get the square root of 6n plus 19 equal to n plus 2. Now we can square both sides since we only have a radical on one side of our equation. So squaring both sides, we'll get 6n plus 19 on the left-hand side, and on the right-hand side, we have n plus 2 squared. And n plus 2 squared is in the form of a plus b squared, which is equivalent to a squared plus 2ab plus b squared. So we'll have n squared plus 2 times n times 2, which will be 4n, plus 2 squared, which is 4. Now I'll subtract 6n from both sides, and I'll also subtract 19 from both sides. That way, I have 0 on one side of my equation and the quadratic on my other. So I'll have 0 equal to n squared plus 4n minus 6n is negative 2n, so we'll subtract 2n, and then 4 minus 19 is going to be a negative 15, so we'll subtract positive 15. Now we can factor n squared minus 2n minus 15. So we need to see what two numbers multiply to give us negative 15 and add to give us negative 2. So looking at the factors of 15, that will be 3 and 5, where, because this is negative 2, that 5 will be negative, because 3 minus 5 is negative 2, and 3 times negative 5 is negative 15. So we'll have 0 equal to n plus 3 times n minus 5. So we'll need to see when n plus 3 equals 0 and when n minus 5 equals 0. Well, n plus 3 equals 0 when n is equal to a negative 3. And n minus 5 equals 0 when n is equal to a positive 5. So these are our solutions when we factor that quadratic. But let's check them with this original equation. However, I'm going to check them after we had added the n to each side. So that was the square root of 16n plus 19 equal to n plus 2. So if we were to plug negative 3 in for n, negative 3 plus 2 would equal a negative 1. And we know that the square root of a quantity cannot have a negative value. Therefore, n is equal to a negative 3 is not a solution. But if we were to plug 5 in, we would get that 5 plus 2 equals a positive 7, which is a valid solution. Therefore, in number 22, we have one solution, and that's n equals 5. So in set notation, we have 5. Let's continue on to number 23. In number 23, we'll start by subtracting 4 from both sides. So we'll have the square root of negative 3m plus 10 equal to m minus 4. So now I'll be able to square both sides in order to remove that radical. So we'll have negative 3m plus 10 equal to m minus 4 squared. So now we're in the form of a minus b squared, which will give us a squared minus 2ab plus b squared. So the only difference between a minus b squared and a plus b squared is whether that 2ab is subtracted or added. When we're subtracting b, we're going to be subtracting 2ab. So that'll be m squared minus 2 times 4 times m, which is 8m, plus b squared, 4 squared, which is 16. Now I'm going to add 3m to both sides, and I'm also going to subtract 10 from both sides, moving my 3m to the other side and my 10 to the other side. So I'll have 0 is equal to m squared, and then negative 8m plus 3m will be a negative 5n, so m squared minus 5m, and then 16 minus 10 will be a positive 6. So m squared minus 5m plus 6. Now we're going to see what two numbers multiply to give us positive 6 and add to give us negative 5. And that's going to be 2 and 3. but it's going to be a negative 2 and a negative 3, because negative 2 times negative 3 is positive 6, and negative 2 plus negative 3 is a negative 5. So we'll have 0 equal to m minus 2 times m minus 3. So we need to see when m minus 2 equals 0 and when m minus 3 equals 0. Well, m minus 2 equals 0 when m is equal to a positive 2, because 2 minus 2 is 0. So 0 times any quantity will be 0. And m minus 3 equals 0 when m is equivalent to a positive 3, because 3 minus 3 equals 0, and 0 times any quantity is 0. So now we have two solutions when we solve for the factors of our quadratic. However, we need to double check with our original equation. And I'm going to write it to where we have the radical only on one side with nothing else. So that was after I subtracted 4. So the square root of negative 3m plus 10 equals m minus 4. So if I take my m value of 2 and plug that in for m, 2 minus 4 equals a negative 2. But when I take the square root of a number, I will not get a negative answer. Therefore, m cannot equal positive 2, because when I plug 2 in, I have a negative solution that's equal to a square root, which I know is not possible. So let's plug in 3. When I plug in 3 for m, I'll have 3 minus 4, and that also is equal to a negative solution, which I know is not possible. Therefore, in number 23, there are no solutions. So my answer is no solutions for number 23. Let's continue on to number 24. In number 24, I have my radical all by itself, so I can start by squaring both sides. X minus 5 squared is in the form of a minus b squared. So that's a squared, which is x squared, minus 2 times a times b, so minus 2 times x times 5, which is minus 10x, and then plus b squared, so that's plus 25. And that's equal to the square root of x plus 1 squared, which is x plus 1. So I'll subtract x from both sides, and I'll subtract 1 from both sides. So we'll have x squared minus 11x plus 24 equal to 0. Since negative 10x minus x will be a negative 11x, and 25 minus 1 is positive 24. So I need to see what two numbers multiply to give me 24 and add to give me negative 11. Well, looking at the factors of 24, that's going to be 3 and 8, where both the 3 and 8 are negative, because negative 3 plus negative 8 is a negative 11, and negative 3 times negative 8 is positive 24. So we'll have x minus 3 times x minus 8, and that's equal to 0. So I need to see when x minus 3 and when x minus 8, both of those quantities equal 0. X minus 3 equals 0 when x is equivalent to a positive 3. 3 minus 3 is 0. And x minus 8 equals 0 when x is equal to a positive 8, because 8 minus 8 equals 0. Now, I need to double check each of these solutions with my original equation. And because my original equation has the radical all by itself on one side already, I'll be able to double check right away. So I'll see x minus 5 equals the square root of x plus 1. So if I was to plug a 3 in for x, I would get 3 minus 5, which equals a negative 2. And I know that the square root cannot equal a negative number. Therefore, 3 is not a solution. Now let's double check with 8. 8 minus 5 equals a positive 3. And that can indeed equal the square root. And because that's positive, 8 is indeed my answer. So 8 is the only solution in number 24. In number 25, when I square both sides, I have a minus b squared. So n minus 7 is a minus b, so we'll have n squared minus 2 times n times 7, which is 14 times n, and then adding 7 squared, which is 49. That's going to be equal to 3n minus 21. So I'll start by subtracting 3n from both sides. So I'll have n squared minus 17n, but I'm also going to add 21 to both sides. So plus 49 plus 21, which is a positive 70. That is equal to 0. So now I can just factor n squared minus 17 in plus 70. So looking at the factors of 70, we'll have 7 and 10, and they'll both be negative, because negative 7 times negative 10 is a positive 70, and negative 7 minus 10, or negative 7 plus negative 10, is a negative 17. So I'll have n minus 7 times n minus 10, and that's equal to 0. So I need to see when n minus 7 equals 0, and when n minus 10 equals 0. N minus 7 equals 0 when n is equal to a positive 7. And n minus 10 equals 0 when n is equal to a positive 10. Because 7 minus 7 equals 0 and 10 minus 10 equals 0. And 0 times any quantity is 0. So now I'm going to look at my original equation, which is n minus 7 equal to the square root of 3n minus 21, and see if n minus 7 is less than 0. So if n minus 7 gives me a negative number, then I know that solution is not valid. So let's plug in 7 for n. 7 minus 7 equals 0, so n equal to 7 is a solution. And let's double check n equal to 10. Plugging 10 in for n, 10 minus 7 equals a positive 3. So 10 is also a solution. Therefore, in number 25, our solutions are 7 and 10. Moving on to number 26, again, I can start by squaring both sides. B minus 6 squared is in the form of a minus b squared. So we'll have b squared minus 12b plus 6 squared, which is 36. And that 12b was from 2 times 6 times b, or 2 times b times 6. And that's going to be equal to 18 minus 3b. So I'm going to add 3b to both sides, and I'm also going to subtract 18 from both sides in order to get 0 on one side of my equation. So I'll have b squared plus negative 12b plus 3b is going to be a negative 9b, so subtracting 9b, and then I'll be adding 36 minus 18, which is a positive 18, and that's equal to 0. So I'm going to be factoring b squared minus 9b plus 18. So I need to see what two numbers multiply to give me 18 and add to give me a negative 9. And that's going to be 6 and 3, but where the 6 and 3 are negative. So b minus 3 times b minus 6 is the factored form of b squared minus 9b plus 18. Because negative 3 times negative 6 is a positive 18, and negative 3 plus negative 6 is a negative 9. So now we're solving for when b minus 3 equals 0, and we're solving for when b minus 6 equals 0. B minus 3 equals 0 when b is a positive 3, because 3 minus 3 equals 0. And b minus 6 equals 0 when b is a positive 6, because 6 minus 6 equals 0. Now I need to double check with my original equation to see if both those solutions are still valid, or if any are still valid. So we have b minus 6 equal to the square root of 18 minus 3b. Plugging in the 3 for b, I'll get 3 minus 6, which will give us a negative 3. We cannot have a negative answer that's equivalent to the square root of some quantity, therefore b equals 3 is not a solution. Now let's try for when b equals 6. 6 minus 6 equals 0, and because 0 is not negative, b equal to 6 is a valid solution. Therefore, 6 is our answer in number 26. Moving on to number 27, I need to start by adding the 3 to both sides in order to square that radical to remove it. So adding 3 to both sides, I'll get the radical all by itself, so I'll have the square root of m plus 59, and that's going to be equal to m plus 3. So now I can square both sides. So I'll get m plus 59 equal to m plus 3 squared, which is in the form of a plus b squared. So that'll be a squared plus 2ab plus b squared. So a squared is m squared plus 2 times m times 3 will be 6m plus 3 squared, which is 9. Now I'll subtract m from both sides, and I'll also subtract 59 from both sides. So I'll have 0 on my left-hand side equal to m squared plus 5m minus 50, since 9 minus 59 is a negative 50. Now I'll factor m squared plus 5m minus 50. Well, the two numbers that multiply to give me negative 50 and add to give me positive 5 are negative 5 and 10. And the 5 is negative because negative 5 plus 10 does indeed equal positive 5. So we'll have 0 equal to m minus 5 times m plus 10. So I need to see when m minus 5 equals 0 and when m plus 10 equals 0. M minus 5 equals 0 when m is equal to a positive 5. And m plus 10 equals 0 when m is equal to a negative 10. So I'm going to double check each of these with the equation in which my radical is all by itself. So I'll look at the square root of m plus 59 equal to m plus 3. And remember, this m plus 3 needs to be positive. So plugging in 5 for m, I'll get 5 plus 3, which indeed is a positive 8. So m equal to 5 is a valid solution. So now let me try plugging in negative 10. If I plug in negative 10 for m, I'll get negative 10 plus 3, which results in a negative 7. And again, I cannot have a negative equal to the square root of some quantity. Therefore, negative 10 is not a solution. So I have one solution to number 27, and that is 5. Now lastly, on this video and in this worksheet, I'm going to be going over number 28. If you haven't done so up until this point, please click that like button and subscribe to my channel. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated, and just show your support. So now that you've hopefully done that, let's go over number 28. We need to start by getting this radical all by itself. So we're going to add a to both sides. So we'll have the square root of 7a minus 54 equal to a minus 6. So now we can square both sides. 7a minus 54 will equal a minus 6 squared, which is in the form of a minus b squared. So that's going to be a squared minus 2ab, which is 2 times a times 6, which is minus 12a. And then I'll add that to b squared, which is 6 squared, and that's 36. So now I'll subtract 7a from both sides in order to get rid of that 7 on my left-hand side, and I'll add 54 to both sides in order to get rid of that 54 on my left-hand side. So I'll have 0 equal to a squared minus 19a plus 90. Since negative 12a minus 7a is negative 19a, and 36 plus 54 is 90. Now that I have a quadratic, I'm going to factor that. So we'll have 0 equal to a minus 9 times a minus 10, because negative 9 times negative 10 is a positive 90, and negative 9 plus negative 10 is a negative 19. So we're going to be seeing when a minus 9 equals 0 and when a minus 10 equals 0. Well, a minus 9 equals 0 when a is equal to a positive 9, and a minus 10 equals 0 when a is equal to a positive 10. So we'll plug in 9 and 10 for a back into our original equation to see if it holds true. But as opposed to plugging into that very first equation, we're going to plug in to when we get the radicals set by itself. So that'll be the square root of 7a minus 54 equal to a minus 6. If we were to plug 9 in for a, we'll get 9 minus 6, which is a positive 3. So because that 3 is positive, that is indeed a solution. Now we'll plug in 10 for a. When 10 equals a, 10 minus 6 equals a positive 4. So because the 4 is positive, then a equals 10 is also a solution. So number 28, we have two solutions, 9 and 10. And with that last answer, we wrap up this video and this worksheet. If you have anything to note, put it in the comments below. And if you didn't do so before number 28, like, subscribe, and share.